Good morning. Well, I set my cup of coffee here so I can actually look towards the camera and not look at myself. Good morning. It is Saturday, November the 4th or the 5th? One of those. Anywho, I figured I'm at Starbucks. Caramel brulee latte. Brulee. Remember the brulee. Oh, that's good. That is good. So, I figured that I would talk to you guys real quick. A lot of stuff that's going on that you guys actually didn't know what was going on. And I made the video using the GoPro, and apparently the volume didn't work, so now I've moved to the phone. But anywho, I just wanted to give you the Reader's Digest version of the last year of my life. Don't have to, just kind of doing it. It's kind of therapeutic. I would say May of last year, 2015, I got married. Yes, and I thought, oh God, life is good. All this is going to work out. Everything is awesome. And no. And it turned out to be one of the worst things that I have ever done in my life. I won't go into a lot of the details, but in October of last year, October 3rd, I left, and I was done. I was in such a bad state that I would go visit the VA, and I was getting a checkup, and the doctor was just talking to me about some piddly whatever stuff, and then I was just making comments, and I guess she caught on to it, and I was talking about leaving this world. I was suicidal. I was deeply depressed, and I was suicidal, and they were talking about, you know, asking who's your, you know, going through it, is this the same, that the same, who's your contact, whatever, and I was like, I don't have a contact. I think I said, if I did, I don't even have anybody to bury me, or I wouldn't be here. And she was like, whoa, back that up. I just kind of had a moment, and I lost it there, and they wouldn't let me leave. I think they almost put me in the mental ward. I was really gone beyond, and I was on suicide watch for a couple of weeks. Somebody was calling me every single day, checking on me all day. All day. They were on me, and they put me on some feel good stuff, but didn't work. A lot of it don't work. It doesn't work. So what I did was I basically quit living. I stopped. But November last year, I got my motorcycle license, because I've been trying to do that. And after I got my motorcycle license, I hadn't rode a motorcycle again until like July of this year, the 3rd to be exact, when I got my first motorcycle, which was a 2016 Street Glide Special. Looked like just like Sean Smoke. And yeah, so I did that. And but I was still riding the roller coaster of depression. I was following his vlogs, and I started commenting, and then I don't know how me and Kelly started talking. she was commenting, answering my comments, and I was commenting back, yes, I do know. And I sent those guys a video. Aha. And, you know, tell them how much I appreciate. You know, I'm watching two people who love each other. And, you know, yeah, I just thought it was awesome what they were doing in front of the camera and how they was keeping it real. And after that, we just started talking, chit-chatting, and it was good therapy for me up here. So I was like, you know what? I got to go see these people. I have to go see these people. Now, I've never, my motorcycle experience is zero. Zip zero. So to say that I rode like 2,000 miles to go see somebody on a motorcycle, I like to drive. So if I was driving, hey, that would have been on point. But no, I was on a motorcycle. So that being said, I love Kelly Smoke because my Shonda went to Yellowstone. I was really bad. Depression, still fighting depression. And me and her stayed up and we talked a lot. And she shared a lot of family close stuff with me. And I was like, what they had went through in their family. And I was like, she's like, you can't never give up hope, baby. It's like, keep praying. It's not over yet. Just when you think there's no hope at all, something will open up for you. She said, and she would listen to me talk the way I was talking. She was kicking me in my butt from long distance. Oh my God. That's a tough one. Kelly Smoke, she's a bad mamma jamma. That lady is something else. She's really special. And I love her, Sean, and Pops, who's I know somewhere right now. Carl, he's making wine, and he's kicking it in the butt with some vodka. Okay, so I just needed to see some a change of scenery, something new, something different, and I got on a motorcycle and I drove across the country in 2 days, which they said is unheard of, but you know, I don't know the rules as far as riding a motorcycle, so doing over 1,000 miles in a day, ain't nobody, you know, I don't know the rules, so that's what I did, and I got there, and they just, she loved on me, and Sean is awesome. These two guys, they're so awesome. I love them so much. Walter was ready to move. And, but as October last month, on the 3rd, actually the same day I left, which is kind of weird, but my divorce was finally final, and, and now I'm ready to leave Kansas. I'm not staying here. My time here is done. It's just a matter of when and where. I'm tired of working for other people also. So I'm thinking about going abroad, doing some things, entrepreneurship. I'm talking with somebody right now and we're thinking about jumping into a business and just running with it, doing some traveling, going to see the world. So, if you see me somewhere, Facebook Live in it, and that's Walter James Carmichael at Facebook, and because I go live, and you see me in Australia, if you see me in Brussels, if you see me in the UK, if you see me Britain, Ireland, or even Africa, don't let it surprise you, because it's a new season for me in my life. And it's time to move on and it's time to move forward. So, I am a Christian. This is not what I thought my life would be. But, you know, my steps are ordered by the Lord. And I just want you all to know it's not over. No matter how bad it may seem, there is always tomorrow. The sun will rise again. Storms never last. So, this is Bear saying keep the shiny side up. Keep it between the ditches. Love and hug on somebody today. The Lord loves you and I love you too, and there's nothing you can do about it. Shout out to Kelly and Sean Smoke, Cowboy, St. Louis, Brian, Greg, Red, Seattle. Hey, I love you all. I will talk to you later. Goodbye.